Well, the Department of Foreign Affairs has made very urgent inquiries and are continuing to ask for details about what has occurred here. Zomi Frankcom was an Australian aid worker working for the World Central Kitchen. She was doing extraordinarily valuable work, as she is someone who I have been in recent times been given some of what her background is. This is someone who volunteered in Australia to help people during the bushfires. This is someone who was volunteering overseas to provide aid through this charity for people who are suffering tremendous deprivation in Gaza. And this is just completely unacceptable. Australia expects full accountability for the deaths of aid workers, which is completely unacceptable. Aid workers and those doing humanitarian work, and indeed all innocent civilians, need to be provided with protection. Australia has had a very clear position of supporting a sustainable ceasefire, of calling for it for some period of time, of calling for humanitarian aid to go to the people of Gaza who are suffering from this deprivation, to make sure that hostages are released as well. Australians want to see an end to this conflict. Australians want to see a peaceful, long-term political solution. That means justice for Palestinians and a Palestinian state, as well as the right of Israel to exist within secure borders. That is what we need to see. But this news today is tragic. DFAT have also requested a call-in from the Israeli ambassador to Australia as well. We want full accountability for this, because this is a tragedy that should never have occurred.
Do you plan to contact the Israeli government directly
then? We certainly have already contacted the Israeli government directly. We are contacting the Israeli ambassador to ask for accountability here. The truth is that this is beyond any reasonable circumstances. Someone going about providing aid and humanitarian assistance should lose their life. And there were four aid workers as well as Palestinian driver in this vehicle. This is a human tragedy that should never have occurred, that is completely unacceptable. And Australia will seek full and proper accountability, as you would expect, for how this could have occurred. Look, with respect, news is just coming through of that. So, of course, the Australian government always will reach out to the family and friends. And my sincere condolences to all who knew Zomi Frankcom. I didn't have the honour of knowing her, but the sort of values that are shown by someone going into a very dangerous place in order to assist mankind, their fellow humans, people who she didn't know, she just wanted to help out through this charity. It says everything about the character of this young woman. And so this is a tragedy, and my sincere condolences and that of the Australian government go to Zomi's family, to her friends and all who knew her, to all who are working in charity, including through the World Central Kitchen. But Australians, wherever there are difficulties in the world, you will find Australians helping out. It's something about our character that comes to the fore during the most difficult of times that we see the best of the Australian character.
on Gaza, are you concerned that more civilians will die or be injured in this war?
I'm concerned about every innocent civilian losing their life during this conflict. I have been very concerned when you look at the number of innocent lives who've been lost in Gaza and in Israel. It is completely unacceptable. We have had a very clear position from the very beginning in the resolution that was carried in the Parliament that said that the events of October 7, that terrorist attack, was something that we unequivocally oppose. We've said that hostages should be released. We've said that innocent people need to be protected and that international law needs to be observed. We have issued two statements from myself, the Prime Minister of Canada and the Prime Minister of New Zealand. We've issued the Melbourne Declaration along with ASEAN leaders about the need for a ceasefire which is sustainable. We've called for and continue to call for a political solution, which means a two-state solution to benefit in the long term both Israelis and Palestinians to be able to live in security with peace and prosperity.